Did you know that the SQL engine has AI and ML baked into it so you can automatically tune your database? Learn all about it this week on Data Exposed MVP Edition. Hi, I'm Anna Hoffman, and welcome to this episode of Data Exposed MVP Edition. Today, I'm joined by Hugo. Hugo, thanks so much for joining us today. Can you tell us a little bit about what you do?
Thank you very much, Anna, and welcome, everyone. My name is Hugo Barona. I'm a cloud solutions architect, so on my daily basis, I work with customers, helping them to adopt and design solutions in the cloud and on Azure as well, of course.
Awesome. Cool. Well, it's great to have you on the show. And this is an exciting episode because we're going to be talking about automatic tuning. And, you know, as people are getting all excited about AI and intelligence and that sort of thing, like automatic tuning maybe is something folks might care about. So I'll just pass over to you. Like, Hugo, can you tell us, like, what is automatic tuning? Why do people use it? How does it work?
Yeah, essentially, this is a service that is available on SQL workloads. And essentially, the concept of this session is to just give you an high-level understanding about automatic tuning and also show you in a demo how you can get started using automatic tuning. Okay, so can I get started?
Yeah. Anna?
All good. Okay, so we start with, of course, understanding what is automatic tuning. So as I said, it's pretty much a fully managed service available on Azure and also on-premise on your SQL workloads. That has some built-in intelligence that you can leverage to pretty much optimize and tune the performance of your SQL database, okay? And of course, these use, behind the scenes, it uses artificial intelligence and machine learning. So it has models working there and running, processing all the data that is provided from the queries that you are running against your database. And those models are learning patterns from all those queries to try to understand if there are any performance opportunities to improve the performance of the queries and also the database, okay? And of course, the service itself is continuously monitoring and tuning the performance of your database and also gives you different options, including, for example, creating a missing index on your related to your queries or required from your queries, drop existing index that are no longer useful, or even force the last good plan in case you have any query that is running using a query plan that is not optimized to run the query, okay? And the good news is this service is essentially available on your on Azure, on your Azure SQL and also a SQL managed instance resource, but also it is available on your on-premise and private data center SQL workloads, okay? As long as you are using the version 2017 or upwards, okay? And last but not least, one important dependency on this service is, of course, it relies on the query store feature that was introduced from SQL Server 2016. And that means that the database that you want to enable automatic tuning is required to have pre-enabled the query store. Okay. With that, we just move to the next slides. This slide, I just want to give you an high-level overview about how all this works in a visual way. So this image was extracted from the documentation available on Microsoft Learn. So on the top, you have all your database running side by side. And then you have the built-in intelligence available on automatic tuning that is capturing all the data from all the different queries that you are running against your database and processing all this data and also identifying patterns. So then those models can learn how to improve and optimize as much as possible the performance of your database, okay? And then once it finds and identifies performance opportunities and performance recommendations, then it picks the low usage periods to then apply those recommendations to your database without impacting your end users and your applications, okay? Once it applies the recommendations, the process doesn't end there. So it continuously verifies and monitors the performance of your queries and your database in order to ensure that there were performance gains related to the recommendations and the changes that it applied. If there are no gains, essentially what it does is it rolls back the change in order to ensure that it doesn't impact your database. Okay. So with that, this is just in the essence of time, it's just a few slides that I have to you. And we are going to start with the demo, if that's okay, Anna.
Awesome. Yeah, let's take a look. I'm always excited to see this thing in action.
All right. So I start by showing you the Azure portal. Okay. Here, I of course, in the essence of time, I created all the resources in advance. So essentially what I created was a SQL server on Azure. And this SQL server contains two databases, okay? Why I created two databases? Because I want to show you two different ways that you can use the automatic tuning. In this case, I have a DB auto-tuning demo, okay? Which is pretty much created using the Azure portal and using the sample data set that you have available there, which is the AdventureWorks LT. AdventureWorks is just a fictitious bicycle manufacturing company that pretty much provides bicycle materials. And these data sets are provided by Microsoft, so you can give it a try on this. The second database, it's the AdventureWorks 2019. So essentially, I downloaded the backup of the database from the Microsoft website. The link will be in the reference of this video, so you can access it as well. And then I just restored locally. I have on my local machine running SQL Server, and I used SQL Server Management Studio to do the restore of the backup and then deploy the database to Azure, okay? So I have essentially two databases. Now, what I want essentially to do is, once I have the database, of course, remember, automatic tuning is all about understanding the queries that you are running. So that means I had to create a way to run queries, okay? And in order to do that, I'm gonna just show you two different ways that you can do it. First, I just installed SQL Query Stress, which is a free app that you can install. This app, I find it quite handy because you can configure a number of iterations, you can configure number of threads in case you want to run queries in parallel, and also you can configure delay between queries in order to avoid make your database unresponsive, okay? And here on the left, you can query configure your queries to run against your database. Here on the left, you can see we have the first query that just does a join between the product's database and product table and the transaction history table, and pretty much tries to list the transaction history, so transactions related to different products, okay? The key takeaway from this query to assess the how automatic tuning will detect the issues related to this query is that we are applying a filter here using the transaction type column, okay, which is a column that is not indexed. So consequently, this query has some performance opportunities. In case you want to verify this, you can always, of course, open Data Studio, okay? So Azure Data Studio, you just install, it's a free tool. And then if I just go here to new query to the database, if I just enable here actual plan and run the query, then you clearly can see here that the studio just says to you, okay, there is a missing index to just ensure that this query has the best performance as possible, okay? And this is exactly what we want to see if automatic tuning is able to identify, okay, in an automated way. So going back to the portal, the other thing I just want to show you, just an FYI, is the fact that I have here as well another way to run your queries if you can't run in your local machine. I just created an automation account, and I just created, in this case, a runbook using PowerShell. And then I just configured a few queries here for the to run against the customer table to just iterate the different customers available in this database and then do some queries using different columns, not indexed columns, remember, so we can identify the issues using automatic tuning, including the first name, okay? Now, let's go back to our resource group. And in here, I'm going to start with the first database, so the DB auto-tuning demo. So when you go to your database, on the left, you can actually navigate here on the blades, and you have here intelligence performance, okay? So here you have multiple options, some complementary features as well, including performance overview that you can see how many recommendations you have available, the tuning activity, the options configured for automatic tuning, and also the graph that provides you metrics to understand how impactful these positively or negatively these are these queries impacting your database, okay? So then on the left, you also have the performance recommendations, okay? So automatic tuning relies on these performance recommendations to try to understand what are the performance recommendations identified, okay? On the first database, as you can see here, we have a recommendation related to the customer table and related to, in this case, the first name column, okay, which is the one that I told you that I'm running a query to just try to get the details of a customer using their first name, okay? So clearly, this recommendation is saying, okay, you need to create a non-clustered index and to this schema, to this table, and to this column, okay? You can also use here the view scripts in order to get the scripts and then execute the scripts manually. So you can assess the recommendations you have available before applying them. Okay, this is an example of using, in this case, the manual deployment of automatic tuning. Okay. And also you can apply here from the Azure portal. You just come here, select the option to apply, and then just wait for the service to apply the recommendation in your database, okay? Now, the important detail is on the left as well, you have automatic tuning, okay? And in here, you can see that we have here three options. We have the force plan to force the last good plan, as I told you, to ensure that your queries are always using the best plan as possible. And also you have query index, create index and drop index. By default, this service has the force plan as on, activated, and the create index and drop index as off, disabled. Okay, so you need to enable them. So this is the scenario that I wanted to show you that you can use this by applying manual deployment. So that means you get notification, you can configure email notifications when performance recommendations are identified, and then you assess those recommendations, and then you apply manually those recommendations to your database, okay? Last but not least, you have also a really useful feature here, which is the query performance insight that enables you to understand what are the queries that you are executing and understand what is the problem with each of the queries, okay? As you can see here, we have here one query related to the customer table. There is a join with sales order header to just get some information about the sales and for a given order. But the key takeaway is this query is using the first name, and consequently, if you go here on the top to recommendations, then you have the recommendation here associated with the query. So you can understand what is the query that is causing the issue and what is the solution for to the issue that you are facing in terms of performance. Okay, last but not least, if we just navigate back to the second database, I just want to show you quickly here on the left, we have here automatic tuning. This time I have here, as you can see, I have all the settings on, okay? The idea is to let the service automatic tuning to apply all the modifications required to optimize the performance. And consequently, if I go to performance recommendation, I can see here on the tuning history, because of course this service provides you a history of all the actions that are applied. And you can see here that there is a recommendation that currently it's being applied, okay, it's executing for the transaction history table and to the transaction type column. Remember that query that I showed you, that we were filtering by transaction type. So the service was able to identify, okay, this column is not indexed, and consequently to optimize the performance of this query, we need to create this index, okay? With that, this is just in a nutshell, an overview of how you can get started to use this service. Again, you can use the reference links available in this session, and you can also access one GitHub repo that I just created with all the full guides that you can follow with all the steps, so you can reproduce this demo and show to your teams and show to your organizations the potential of this service. Okay. Thank you very much.
Thanks so much, Hugo, for coming on the show. I learned a lot. It's always great to see kind of the different workflow that leads to an index being recommended or force last good plan. And then what's set at the default. It's great to know that. Great to see it in action. And it's great that you have all these scripts that you're going to make available to folks on GitHub and maybe also in a blog post. So we'll put all the links to that in the description. So if you like this episode, go ahead, check out those resources. Try this out for yourself. It's really powerful technology that we're able to give you in Azure SQL database automatically and in some other places as well. And if you like this episode, go ahead, give it a like, leave us a comment and let us know what you think. And we hope to see you next time on Data Exposed.